Their leader had gone to college 4 years ago and never returned. They were a crew with no captains, just a first mate, a bosun, and a cabin boy. They threw good parties, but not the best.
When I call my best friend, I expect a response.
Phone's just been on silent all day. I'm sorry, man.
You stink of lies. Taking out the garbage, garbage man.
Yep, doing the garbage and the like. Just waiting to hear back from Faye.
The Sam Hell's Faye?
I told you about Faye. She's a chick from Purchase Party, Orson's friend. One of the interests, you know?
Oh, right, the large interest.
Yeah.
When are you doing that?
I don't know, when she gets off work. Dark time, I guess.
Dark time.
Dark time.
Let's go for a walk.
Why?
Because I don't like getting serious standing still.
Alright, what's up?
I hung out with Jessica last night.
Uh-huh.
Things got a little...
Well, who? Fat Jessica?
No, not Fat Jessica.
Freckly? Freckly Jessica?
No. No, that freckly ship is long since sailed.
Weird Jessica?
No, not weird. No. Less weird, more incredibly... Buxom.
Rojas? Wait, isn't she, you know...
She does, yeah. And he's 6 feet, 2 inches of pure sloth at best.
Why would you do this? This is like your old friend.
I don't know. She said they hadn't had sex in like a month.
Oh, so just a month passes, a fortnight has gone by, and then suddenly the night sweeps in and saves her. Is that what's going on?
I must have been wearing Axe body wash or something. There was boxed wine!
Oh.
You know about me and boxed wine?
Apparently Jessica should know about you and boxed wine.
That she does.
Well, as long as Barton doesn't know, I guess.
He will.
What do you mean he will?
I just mean he will. Let's keep walking.
Alright.
A man has to pay the cuckold piper sometime in his life. I mean, even a king like me. Nobody lives forever. In fact, we all die.
Was that Spencer? What the hell are you talking about?
I don't know, man. I was talking to Conrad earlier. He's waiting for us to pick him up.
Alright, we should get him. I feel bad for the poor guy.
No, don't feel bad. He's used to it. It's what he does. It's part of his character. You're the leader. I get the chicks. Conrad waits. Circle of Life, Lion King.
You do remember the Lion King. I remember the Lion King. Alright.
Bang Jessica Rojas.
Oh, you know what? She was a nice girl, too.
Well, she's nice and practically married to Barton Barone.
Well, you know.
Hey, you got any cigarettes?
Nah.
Well, I do. You want one?
No, that's right, man.
So what are we doing today?
Just waiting on a girl, otherwise...
Which
really.
One?
Faye? You remember?
Barton's friend.
Orson.
Orson.
Yeah, yeah.
Big interest.
Yeah, exactly.
You could call Molly.
No, I think Molly's out. She pretty much banned me from her house the last time I broke, like, 10 lamps.
So she has 10 lamps, huh?
10 lamps?
Okay, like, maybe two.
So you broke 2 lamps.
I broke enough to get banned from her house.
All right, okay, so what about, that Greg dude?
Greg? No, yeah. Man, he's in, like, South America. Curing orphans or something. I don't know. I got a postcard.
Curing orphans?
I said curing.
Oh, curing, okay.
Of whatever diseases they might have.
Orphan diseases. Well, what about, like, Victor?
Victor's a cop now.
A cop? Victor?
Yeah, a cop in the city.
What city? What, the
you know,
city?
The city.
All right, okay, all right. Well, So what you're telling me is that as of this moment, we have pretty much no reason to live.
Did we ever have reason to live?
You know what? We could go to that one liquor store. The one with the crazy candy.
Crazy candy?
Crazy candy.
Yeah, man. It's right off 880. Man, they have some fucking crazy candy there sometimes. Let's go. All right,
let's do it.
All right.
I'm hungry. Come on.
Sudden fucking reticence, Jonah. Lay there like the fucking sprawl that you're in and try to tell me it wouldn't be 100% within my rights to beat the fucking shit out of you and let everyone see how ugly and pathetic your fucking brain is. This is your modus operandi, isn't it? You're a fucking island. And everyone else? Fucking adults for you to drop atomic bombs of your malignant fucking bullshit on. I mean, right, wrong? Do you have any clue which is which? I'm asking your stupid ass a serious question here. I'd like a fucking answer. Little League. You remember that fucking shit? The bats and the balls and all that stupid fucking bullshit. I remember that shit vividly like it was fucking yesterday. How about my 6th birthday? You remember that shit? Yeah, you fucking do. You degenerate fuck. You come to my house and start lying to me about my mom. My own house. My own fucking house. You're a joke. You're nothing. No one's gonna give a fuck when you're not around. People are fucking joyous when you leave a room. Fucking tumor. And I'm gonna give you the fucking thrashing with just the kind of malevolence I think you've earned. I mean, I'm gonna give you bruises in places your fucking places didn't even know had places. What the fuck? What the fuck even compelled you to come close to me? Am I handing out absolution here like I'm some fucking Catholic priest? You expect me to be cool? You come and tell me you slept with a woman I love, expecting me to be fucking cool about it? Are you not the worst kind of fucking insane? Stand the fuck up! I don't even need a bat for you. I probably don't need my fucking fists. I won't have to kick the shit out of you without a fight, Jonah. But I will. Jonah? Jonah? What's the matter, you fucking dimwit? No words. Yeah, fucking fear does wonders to the idiotic verbose. As of this second, know that I'm in your world until you fucking die. I'm gonna do everything in my power to fuck your shit up on from here on out. A little bit here, a little bit there, a punch in the face here, a slash tire there. And Jessica, why would you do that to me, you stupid fuck? You didn't torture me enough as a kid, you contemptible fucking lamb. I'm gonna kick your fucking face in. Believe that, if nothing else.
What's up, man?
Hey, James. What's up, man?
How you doing, man?
I'm alright. Dude, what's it been? Like, it's been like 3, 4, 5, like 4 years, right?
Yeah,
4 years, something like
something
that.
Something like that, man.
Shit, man.
How are you? What's up?
Wonderful, wonderful. Just hanging out, you know?
Yeah, that's cool.
Yeah.
So, what's up, man?
I just got notified about, from my agent, like, I just got a book deal, you know? It's pretty sick.
That's great, man.
Yeah, it's tight, dude. It is really, really sick.
Wow, like,
yeah.
Like self-published? What's up?
Well, it's like an imprint of Random House. It's like YA literature.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, man. Yeah. It is tight, dude.
Nice.
You just totally come through, man.
Yeah, man. I'm really proud for you, man. That's good to hear.
Thanks, dude.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, yeah.
Cool. This sounds cool, man.
You remember where I live, right?
Yeah, yeah, like right off Rainbow?
Yeah, right off Rainbow, dude. Yeah, like cruise through?
Halfway down the block?
Yeah, that's right.
Yeah, I might have stopped by.
Yeah, dude, like, how long has it been since creative writing? It's been forever, right?
It's been, seriously, a fucking lifetime. Man,
dude.
Getting a book published, that's...
Yeah.
Seriously, so that's dope. Really cool.
Dude, you're a writer too, man. I mean, come on.
Well, I mean, it's nothing really, but, like, seriously, getting published is a big deal.
I was a bad speller. I remember, like, I used to get hella red ink on my shit, and, like... Oh, it was... Whatever. It doesn't really matter anymore, you know? It's signed. It doesn't matter.
It's amazing what doesn't matter sometimes, huh?
Yeah. You just come through, you do your do, you know.
Yeah, I guess so, man.
That's it.
Well, shit, it's great seeing you, man.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure, G.
Yeah, definitely. All right.
It'll be tight.
All right.
Yeah.
Have a good one.
Yeah, you too. Wait, hold up. Dude, I just got this, I just got the HD.
Yeah.
Check it out. It's like... Looks really good. You gotta see movies on this shit, man.
Sure,
it's
man,
tight.
Yeah, well, all right. Well, you guys have a good time.
Yeah, I'm gonna cruise out with my friend right now, and then, yeah, you should definitely come through later.
Okay, cool. All right, man.
I'll see you later.
So long, man.
One more time.
Yeah, sure.
See you.
All right.
Cool. Congrats,
see you, bro.
See you later.
See you. All right, homie. Peace.
Peace out.
What's with you?
You know what I just saw?
No.
James fucking Jensen.
Oh, yeah, I remember.
Yeah, I had a creative writing class with him at De Anza, and fuck, man, that guy writes the most tepid, safe, saccharine bullshit. The kind of shit that will make Dan Brown wince, man. And fucking, here he is getting published, about to join the ranks of, well, let's say Dan Brown. James Jensen, the published author.
Oh, damn.
I mean, you go through life and you know that people love bullshit, you know? You know that they're going to eat up all the bullshit if you just keep shoving it in their face, but I don't expect to see it right in front of me when I'm just trying to hang out, you know?
Maybe you should just write a better book.
I liked Elastic Man.
Oh, yeah, and what was that other one?
That's not the point. The point is that the entire reason I exist is just to be an alternative to this kind of thing, you know? It's my sole reason.
Oh. Your raison d'etre.
Some heinous shit.
So what are you gonna do?
I'm gonna throw trash all over his yard.
So why would you want to do that, man?
Because this guy lives in the fucking world too, and he needs to be reminded of that. He's not above this.
But throwing trash in his yard, how old are you?
Man, it's not about that. It's not about... This guy is the worst. This is the worst. This is the absolute worst. The bottom of the fucking barrel, below everything. This is just him getting published.
All right, you know,
it's
fine. We'll go throw trash on his yard. Just as long as you know that's not the right thing.
It may not be the right thing, but somebody's gonna fucking do it.
Let's go.
Sean stewed silent rage about James and his young adult triumph. Jonah thought of Jessica Rojas and wondered when it was he strayed from the path. Conrad thought of his court date and the strange fellows he called his friends.
Don't invite me over, I'll just be in a bad mood. I've been looking and finding nothing for me to do. And do not ask me questions like when and where.
Shut up.
It doesn't even taste like anything. It's just like a red rope.
So what's up with Faye? I don't know. She said she'd call me when she's off work.
You think she likes you?
Probably not. What he means is, has she slarved your dode?
No.
No, we only like hung out once. It was kind of awkward, to be honest.
And how was that?
Kind of awkward, to be honest. We just kind of talked small the entire time. So why do you want to see her again?
I don't know.
An awkward hangout does not a dream girl make. Remember Lizette?
Oh. Yeah, you know, she's always hitting on her.
Well, yeah, weren't you?
Oh, man. Definitely not. You know, I was just talking about Voltron a little too loudly. Yeah, I can be a fool when Voltron comes up, okay? Mm-hmm. Oh, you know what? I knew a girl who went to this high school once.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Any good?
Shut up, man. You know, she was nice.
I'm not saying
this girl was nice.
I believe it. I'm not saying
she
that.
Let me tell the story. Right, she was nice. Ahead. You know, like... I don't think I've ever really had a concept of love, you know? Mm-hmm. But I think, like, when I met her, I think I was in love, you know?
Yeah? What makes you say that? I don't want to get too personal, I'm just wondering.
We just hung out sometimes, you know, and it was like, I'd take the bus, you know, across town, it took about 6 hours, and I didn't care, because she wanted my company. Then she had to move away. Somewhere on the East Coast. I think her father was like a pastor, so. Something like that.
Wow. Do you know the worst pickup line I ever used on a girl?
No, why would I? Have you told me? Before?
No. Never mind.
You know what? I used to volunteer for these middle school kids in East Palo Alto. And there was this woman. She was like, real young. You know, she had a kid when she was like 14 or 15. And we even got to talking once. No, you know, I took her to dinner once. And, I couldn't think of anything to say to impress her, so I just taught her how to negate a 212 zone.
What the fuck is a 212 zone?
Man, that's basketball. Even I know that.
Yeah, you know, weak side help. It's good against good pivot players.
All right, okay. I believe you. Okay. All right.
What's that? Let me see. Dumbest Gods. Is this a metal band? I hate metal.
You love metal. Nobody hates metal.
I hate metal. Is this for a chick? Are you gonna give a chick a mixtape called Dumbest Gods?
Damaged Goods.
Why haven't you mentioned it yet?
It's too early, man. I made it for the night.
You didn't make it, though, for a girl, though, right?
No.
Okay, because remember, we outlawed that. You were there when we made that law.
I was.
That was rule number one. No mixtapes for girls.
That's the second rule, too. Alright, well, we're losing daylight. Might as well just head in face direction.
Wait a minute. Hanging out with a girl and throwing trash on a guy's lawn, that's not gonna overlap, is it?
Maybe. Maybe not. Nothing is written.
It's been
Yeah. This is so us. Right?
Jonah, he takes the longest pisses.
It's only been about 10 seconds, man.
Takes like 20 minutes. You know it.
Yeah. Because it's his alone time or whatever.
Yeah, it's precious to him.
Hey, you remember that party at Ferber's house?
Which one?
The one with the trampoline? Jonah gets up to take one of his pisses. We're all laying there in the trampoline. Everyone just gets up and starts jumping. He's right on the edge.
And he flies off the trampoline, still taking a piss.
Hands in the fucking bush, pissing all over himself.
Yeah. You know, that happens to be, I would say, the single best moment of my life. And Jonas.
Well, yeah, he did live with Laura that night, despite, you know, being covered in his own doings.
Yeah, I guess a little piss couldn't scare her away.
She's a nice girl. I always kind of liked her.
I think we all did, man.
Yeah. You know, there's something about this Faye girl. It actually reminds me of Laura.
In what way?
I don't know exactly. I just get the same sort of like moss in my stomach feeling, you know? It's good. Have you heard about Jonah's mom at all recently?
No.
I was thinking about visiting her, but I don't know if that's appropriate.
I was thinking the same thing.
Yeah?
Yeah.
We should go. Next week. You want
to? Sounds good. Why not?
Man, he should visit her.
To be honest, I really don't think that's any of our business.
Shit, man, I have no business. You know that. Hey, you think we got enough trash for tonight? That mean no?
Whatever, man.
So the 501s are the classics with the button-up fly, and the 505s are the 501 except with a zipper.
So what does that make yours?
These are 514s, and they're awesome. You should definitely get 514s.
I've never worn jeans. You know I never wear jeans. Why would... Hey, man.
How's it going?
Alright.
Uh-huh. I was just at the train tracks collecting mails. Got six of them. And they're rusted.
Is that a fact?
And two of them were nickels, but they look like nails.
Yeah. Were they rusty?
Six of them. 25 nails.
You gonna
get us into chocolate at all? Some chocolate candies? You guys gonna wear some thermals? Some thermal pants and shirts?
I think we gotta get going, man.
Yeah.
Be sure to buy a lot of thermals. They're calling you. Especially you.
Thanks, man.
Thermals.
Alright, see you later.
Okay. Kid was a ghost.
Were you like 5 years old? He's not a ghost.
Yeah, that kid was a ghost. I'm settled on it.
Dude, that kid was not a ghost.
You see?
I know what ghosts look like, and that is not a ghost.
What the hell are you talking about? I thought you were crazy.
He had legs. That ain't a ghost.
Had legs?
All right. I don't know. He was pale. He was creepy. He hangs around the railroad tracks. Plus.
Come on.
He vanished. The kid's a ghoulie.
Can we just get some gas, man?
All right.
Legs.
He ain't a ghost.
So, all I'm saying is... You know what, yeah, the fan was blowing? I hit that.
Oh, you mean she was possessed?
Yeah, when she was possessed.
Oh, no. I'm more of an aliens guy.
Yeah?
You know, she had, like, the shaved head. Or, like, when she was using that machine, that, and, you know, the whole, like, get away from her, you bitch! You know?
I liked more, there is no Dana, only Zulu.
No, I really like that movie.
Yeah. Hey, hang on a second.
Hello?
Hey, it's Faye.
Hey, what's up, my nigga?
So you told me to call you when I was getting off?
Yeah, so are you off?
I should be. I should just walk out. It's so slow in here.
Yeah, you should.
Well, I can't.
Well, I mean, we're in your basic neighborhood. We can stop by if you want.
Who's we?
Oh, just my friends Conrad and Jonah. I mean, you won't even notice them.
Well, I don't know about tonight. Kind of have a headache, but feel free to come by. Yeah, unless they tell me to come inside. Nobody really gives a shit around here.
Yeah, that sounds kind of like the world.
What?
Oh, I said it sounds kind of like the world.
You cut out.
I said it sounds like the world.
All right, see you then.
Okay, yeah, 10-4, good buddy.
10-4, good buddy.
So did I just fuck that up?
Yes.
So, just chillin', huh?
It's so fucking slow in there. I don't know why they need me.
Well, Faye, these are my friends, Jonah and Conrad.
Ashanté, le one!
Hi.
I don't think she likes me, though.
Voltron again? Jeez.
I probably should have just dropped you guys off.
Dropped us off? But who would help me with the garbage?
Alright, so how bad was that? 1 to 10?
Probably a 6.
A 6? Really?
Yeah, I mean, well, I guess that depends. Is 1 average or is 5 average?
Yeah, 5 is average. Well, how could 1 even possibly be average?
Right, well, I mean, she's meeting you after work. Right? She's not completely repulsed by your presence. I'd say that's at least a 6.
Okay, so I'm a 6. All right. So, right. But there's a difference between wanting to... What are you doing? Oh, shit. We gotta get out of here.
No. I'm gonna go talk to him.
No, don't do this. You can't do that.
Yeah, I mean, he's right there. This is bigger than coincidence.
What do you mean it's bigger than coincidence? He's always here. You know he was gonna be here. We're coming here.
It's time for honor.
What are you... It's way too late for honor. It was time for honor before you fucked his girlfriend.
True. But I have to go talk to him now before he hears from somebody else and I get murdered.
You're gonna get murdered either way at this point, unless we get the fuck out of here, man.
Fine. If not honor, then truth.
I don't know. What the... Can we just go?
What are you talking about? We gotta get out of here. Don't do this. Thank you.
Little League, right? A little days ago. Kevin, remember?
Hi. Man, we just broke out the bats and balls the other day. You know, waxing nostalgic.
Right. So, what's up with you guys?
Some falafels, you know, packing it in. Yeah, I have a presentation on female circumcision tomorrow. I haven't even started to work on it. Not the kind of thing you want to wing, you know what I mean? But, bring you to the shitty side of the tracks.
You remember Sean? He's trying to bang some chick, fag something.
Sometimes.
Not really.
No.
Alright. You gonna head out?
Jonah?
Sorry.
What's up?
Listen, you're still, dating Jessica Rojas, right?
Yeah, 2.5 years now.
2.5, okay. So, I don't know exactly how to say this. I've been thinking a lot about things today.
Go on.
I wanted to tell you that, I slept with Jessica last night.
I can just take you home if you want.
No. I don't want to go home. I want to move or something. I want to go to the mountains or Mexico. I want to go someplace long enough to learn how to become a decent person. I want to be able to make friends with people who actually respect me. I want to be able to throw myself a birthday party once a year with people who actually want to be there. And I want to sleep with a girl from every ethnicity at least once. I'm just tired. I'm tired of myself. I'm tired of fake friends. I'm tired of essays and infidelity.
I just think it's time to grow up.
You're 23 years old, man. You are grown up.
Well, phase off work.
All right. Let's do this.
I feel like Odysseus right now.
Why?
Just been a stupid, crazy night.
Lucky. Better than boring. So what happened to you?
Well, good buddy Jonah decides to sleep with someone else's girlfriend and then decides to be honorable, since there's so much honor in his actions at that point, and tell the guy and gets himself chased with the bat. And here we are, and it's all weird, and it's not been that great, but at least there weren't any fucking lotus eaters or anything.
It can be a fashion of such crooked wood as that which man is made out of.
I might be a little tipsy, but did you just fucking quote Kant?
I did.
Do you like Kant?
Not really.
You just like to randomly quote shit you aren't into?
Have you seen Garden State?
Unfortunately.
Well, every time I hang out with new people, it starts reminding me of that, you know? Everything's not real, too cutesy, too bullshitty. You know what I mean?
Are you telling me you aren't the least bit impressed that I could pull that Kant quote out of thin air? I don't have, like, a cheat sheet or fucking Wikipedia here to go off of. Come on, give me a little bit of recognition. I like other shit too, you know? Like, here, give me your hand. This will prove to you that I'm not a man you meet every day. Brilliant quote recognition aside. Other side, other side. Here. Chaos Theory! You know, Chaos Theory? Like, you know? Ian Malcolm, the new Mrs. X Ian Malcolm? Jurassic Park? Have you seen Jurassic Park? Okay, alright. I'm sorry. I think I can go skate for a second. She's very impressed with me.
Man, why aren't you over there banging that broad?
I don't think she's that impressed with me.
Jeez. I wouldn't be either. What the nerve are you skating around when she's over there? By herself?
Weird night.
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Man, if you don't go over there and make that girl fall in love with you, this entire weird-ass day is officially a failure. I didn't almost get hit by a bat just so you can sit here and sulk.
So, how do you know Sean?
High school. And then on the first day, it was first period, and, he had a big backpack.
answer to the world, the end of the time. Were you just flat to wake you up in the open night? Waking by a lock, 50 minutes of 5J, 20 minutes of meeting, 30 seconds to the door.
Just because that kid was a little coked up doesn't mean he's a ghost.
He wasn't on coke.
He wasn't a ghost.
I think it's a safer bet that he was a ghost. How can a 24-hour donut place be closed? Isn't that impossible?
Oh, I'm hungry, though.
Yeah, me too.
So where are you guys?
Oh, they just they ran across the street to get some donuts. There's a Cambodian guy. Just always haggling over the price of a single donut.
Sounds like one.
Yeah. So who is that on the phone?
Oh, that was Kyle. You may know him. Kyle Lynch. He's one of Orson's groomsmen.
Oh, yes. Kyle. How's he doing?
He's doing really good. He got into Georgetown. Grad school.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah, I'm really proud of him. He worked his ass off. So, yeah.
How about you? You go to school?
Yeah. Stanford pre-med.
That's pretty cool. How's that?
It's alright.
Oh shit, I should have asked. I'm sorry, do you want a donut? I can call them. They're really good. For donuts, I mean, they're really good.
Unless they have French crullers.
No. Cambodian place.
How's it going? I was just down by the railroad tracks collecting nails.
That is fucking fantastic.
Got six of them.
Who the fuck are you, man? Why the fuck are you talking to me?
Sorry.
Oh, whatever, man. Fuck. I got a lot on my fucking plate right now, and I don't really have time to be discussing the finer merits of fucking nails, if you know what I mean.
What happened tonight?
Girl's ex-friend banged my girlfriend. The motherfucking apocalypse happened, man. Fucking betrayal was ubiquitous. Fucking baseball bats were lost, and I was at a fucking Safeway, and... Anyway, whatever. Now I'm gonna collect a posse of the meanest, rudest, toughest motherfuckers that you could conceive of, and I'm gonna go to Homeboy's house and beat the fuck out of him. Is that okay with you?
You're after revenge, then.
Yeah, revenge, yeah. Beautiful, fucking brilliant revenge. I got enough revenge to kill a fucking horse with.
You got a cigarette.
Yeah, I have a life. Have at it.
You know.
What?
Revenge is kind of stupid. It's pointless.
What?
Revenge is stupid. Don't you know that?
What is that, like fucking Wisdom of the Train Tracks? Is it like a hobo psalm? What the fuck?
I don't know.
Listen, dude, what the fuck are you doing out here alone? I mean, don't you have anyone you could be entertaining with your fascinating fucking gibberish?
Not really. Just moved out here. I haven't met anyone yet.
Fuck. What's your name, man?
Charlie.
Barton.
Good to meet you, Barton. Do you like amusement parks?
No. I hate that shit like the plague.
Well, I like it.
Well, different strokes for different lunatics, I guess, right?
You want to see the nails I got?
I don't really know shit about nails, and that's really always been fine with me. Yeah.
You don't really need to know anything about nails to enjoy them.
Yeah. Thanks, by the way.
For what?
Thanks for the bat situation. Could have turned out bad.
Yeah, of course.
So, you think Sean's gonna bang that chick?
Man, I hope so.
I don't.
Where are my friends with their donuts?
Yeah, can we not make it a long night? I have a headache.
That's fine, yeah. I'll just wait for them to get back with their donuts. And then, we just have one thing I need to take care of, and then I'll get you back home.
All right, it's fine.
What kind of a headache? Like stabbing? Dull?
It's throbbing?
Is that a word? Yeah, throbbing.
Are we really gonna do that thing?
What?
Trash James's yard.
Oh yeah, definitely. I mean, we already got the trash from the dumpster, right?
Yeah. But Sean, he's serious?
Yeah. Yeah, he's serious. I've seen it before. He has a really stupid sense of justice. There will be trash on that yard tonight. It's like God's will. Nothing's getting in the way.
One of my favorite writers, a Russian, once wrote that not everything has a name. Some things lead us to a realm beyond words.
Am I a bad guy?
No.
Am I?
No.
But we do bad things.
Well, how do you fix this? How the fuck do you make this right?
You can't. I mean, you could mow his lawn or walk his dog or do something nice for the guy, but you're never gonna make up for that moment. That was the moment, you know? That's what they remember when you're at your worst. When they see you at your worst.
God damn.
I mean, it's like if 40 years from now, if I saved Barton's children from a burning church, he would still never forgive me for sleeping with Jessica. You know, I don't blame him. It's just things like that you can't make up for.
Well, you can't just fucking pay it forward in life, we'll guarantee you that. She'll just chew you up, spit out the seeds, and just remember all the stupid shit you did. Everything good we've done, nobody's gonna remember that. All our good deeds will go unsung, I guarantee you. I am the guy who threw trash on James's lawn because he got a young adult book published. That's who I am.
No, that's not who you are. That's just what you did.
Well, I think we can do a bit better than that, right?
Yeah, we can do better than that. I mean, this throwing trash thing is relatively new.
Well, I have no fucking clue how to proceed from here.
I think I can proceed to bed.
What is wrong with him?
Conrad?
Yeah.
Where to start? What do you mean?
Well, you know, when I talk to people, I like them to look at me in the eye. You know, bare minimum of respect would be nice. Instead, he just stares off, you know, like some kind of weirdo.
He just doesn't like small talk. It repulses him.
I'm tired. Here he comes, to not acknowledge me.
I mean, what the fuck does he do? She's all pissed off.
First of all, what's any of this got to do with me? No, hey, I'm talking to you, so look at me in the eye when I've got something to say, like right now.
All right, okay.
Jonah, you know what I can give a fuck about, because he's all fucked up in the head anyway. Oh, but hey, Jonah, you know what? Being truthful doesn't make you any less of an asshole, but you're trying, so God bless. Oh, really, Sean, is this about you and me? Is it? Or is it about you and her? Or yourself, maybe? Man, don't take it out on me because you can't find some way to impress this girl. Hey, this isn't about me. You know, because if it was, we'd be talking about my court date. Or the fact that, you know what, I'm all fucked up in the head too, but you know what, here I am, man. With you.
Okay, okay.
Fucking around with the both of you. That's right, Jonah. Fuck! Fuck, fuck, fucking around with the both of you all while right. You, Sean, you should be alone with her right now. I mean, look at her. You should be alone figuring out if there's any potential in the past 5 minutes that you so far have spent together before you started fucking it up with me. And I've tried, man. You know, today, I've been trying. But you've been fucking me over all day, man. Haven't you noticed that I've been hungry? I've been wanting to eat, man. I'm fucking starving. Oh, but shit costs money, right? And like you said, we live in this world, right? No, hey, right? We live in this world, yes?
Yeah,
yes,
yeah,
yes,
yeah,
yes,
okay,
yes. We
yes.
live in this world, right? And here, shit costs money. And here, you might want to try making something of yourself from what you've got, man. You know what? Because you've got so much. And it might not be James Jensen much. Listen, listen, listen.
I'm listening.
And it might not be James Jensen
much.
Okay,
okay.
But it's enough. It was enough, man. It was something that I used to believe in. And it's something enough for this broad to find you somewhat interesting, and yet you've got nothing better to do than to trash that poor fucking idiot's house, man. I've been looking forward to hanging out with you today, man, and him. Just so I can forget all of my problems for just 1 minute. But I guess it's doing me some good taking a page out of Mr. What was it, Honor? Mr. Honesty's book here and being completely upfront with you. Come here. Sean, you know what? Sean, you're a tired pussy, man. I don't know why I'm wasting my fucking time with you.
Fucking awkward.
John, go get him.
Why?
What do you mean, why? Because you're the leader. It's your moral imperative.
Man, I just got lambasted in that 5 fucking
seconds. We were just talking about this. It's easy to forsake a friend when your feelings get hurt.
What the fuck did I do to him anyway? What?
You don't listen to him, that's what. And you know what, 9 times out of 10, I don't care that you don't, but now would have been an opportune time to open up your ears and listen to what he had to say. Now just go get him so we can go home at least and end this terrible night for the love of Allah.
Milk crate full of records, a candle lit, coffee table, the night is almost dead. Springs, they relay your heart's reverberating, and the low tones through the ceiling, through the walls, sounds like familiar breathing. For the porches, just a matter of seasons, but we can wait it out. Springtime slaughtered the winter and the silent snow. Like little kids, we wait for summer and listen to the low tones through the ceiling, through the walls, sounds like familiar breathing.
good rights to qualify to talk about life. Nor am I deep enough to even mention love. Yet still my simple-minded contract brain works round and round the clock. Unable to be able to derail the old nail of when will it all stop or likewise restart. Despite my best efforts to grow as a human, the earth spins on its axis, perusing the solar system. Solitary string to me attached, nor a single stroke of luck in love I've had. I am independent and strong, or is it the polar opposites I'm thinking of? As it turns out, boy, what a surprise, I never would have known. The conclusion I concluded is simple, clear, and lucid, and let's go, let's just go.
Their leader had gone to college 4 years ago and never returned. They were a crew with no captains, just a first mate, a bosun, and a cabin boy. They threw good parties, but not the best.